everybody. Let's talk about sex, as in biological sex or biosex. What is it? I'll begin by saying our culture is laden with innumerable misconceptions regarding sex. Society's definition usually goes something along the lines of...
Either of the two main categories, male and female, into which humans and many other living things are divided on the basis of their reproductive functions.
This is a common portrayal of sex that I'd feel safe in assuming most people are very familiar with. Something about sex I don't think many people are familiar with, however, is that it's a social construct. It's a method of classification invented by humans, just like all labels and systems of classification are constructs. Now, don't get me wrong, our body's physicality is not a construct. A person may, for example, have facial hair, XY chromosomes, tons of testosterone flowing through their veins. The way our bodies R is simply undeniable. However, labeling a person like this male based on their physical characteristics is a human design.
I will call you male. Even if there are other parts or variations of your biology that indicate you may not fit perfectly into society's typical definition of the category. Male it is.
After all, body parts are not inherently male or female, they're just body parts.
Pop quiz. This is a male arm, a female arm, an arm. That can't be right. I think if I squint, I can see the arm's sex.
Sex is also a system that is heavily influenced by society's binary views of gender. This is evident by the fact that society only uses two binary sex categories that each have strong associations with the two binary genders. These two sex categories include male, associated with man, and female, associated with woman.
To recap, why am I calling you male instead of recognizing that sex exists on a spectrum? Because I think sex is the same as gender, and since I like the idea of two genders, I conclude there must also be two sexes.
Which classification a person receives is largely based on the following: chromosomes, hormones, gametes, primary sex characteristics, which are present at birth and directly related to reproduction. These include external sex organs, such as the vulva, clitoral glands, penis, and scrotum, and internal sex organs, like the uterus, ovaries, epididymis, and etc. Also, secondary sex characteristics, which are developed during puberty. These are things like body hair, facial hair, muscle-to-fat ratio, larynx size. Society's idea of the perfect specimen in each of these categories might look something like this: a male with lots of testosterone, XY chromosomes, sperm, a penis, testicles, facial hair growth, a deeper voice, broad shoulders, and a more muscular build. While the ideal female would have lots of estrogen, XX chromosomes, ovum, vulva, uterus, little to no facial hair, higher voice, broad hips, and breasts.
Wait. Okay, I have to say something. I'm not sure where I fit in this chart. See, I'm a person with PMDS. In my case, this means that I have all the previously stated characteristics: XY chromosomes, testosterone, a beard, but I also have a uterus and fallopian tubes. Also, where do people with other chromosome variations, like X, XXX, or XXY go on here? This feels like it's missing a lot.
Shh, no, my heuristic is flawless.
That's how science would say sex is classified. But how many of us have had our chromosomes tested? Just saying. Like, how sure are you that you have XX or XY or whatever chromosomes? How sure? And when was the last time you had your hormone levels checked? How can anyone be so sure they fit neatly into one of these boxes? And what if a person knows for sure they don't fit precisely into either side of this table? I think many of us can think of a few people in our lives like this. For example, do you know any guys who can't grow beards? I do. I know, like, a ton. And are you friends with any women who do have facial hair? If not, I'll introduce you to one right now. Me. My face is riddled with about 10 long, dark, stray hairs. A few years ago, I would have never admitted to this. And now I'm putting it on the internet. I used to be hella insecure of the hairs on my chinny chin chin, but since then I've met several women who also grow facial hair.
Women don't grow facial hair. Look at the chart.
Some have random stray hairs like me.
No, this can't be.
Some have hairy upper lips.
I don't believe it.
And some can grow beards.
You liar.
I see now that having some hair on your face is a natural and not uncommon characteristic for females.
Liberal propaganda.
Need more examples? There are also females with broad shoulders and prominent Adam's apples, just as there are some males who grow breasts and can't produce sperm. We need to understand in many ways that while there are biological patterns, they are not rules. We need to understand in many ways that while there are biological patterns, they are not rules. They are not rules. They are not rules.
Oh, that actually makes a lot of sense.
However, we often talk about sex and gender as if there are rules. Rules that if your body does not follow, deem you inferior or strange. This is something we need to start challenging and changing. Biological sex is not so clear-cut.
Maybe I need to revise my chart a bit.
If you liked this video, the entire script was from my book. I'll put the link to that in the description. And stay tuned for this channel's next video, which will cover what it means to be intersex. And it's gonna have a hella dope guest. Okay, bye!
Hey there, ho there, before you go there, don't forget to click that link. The YouTube algorithm works in very strange ways. A click's the best way to give Ash Hardell your praise. So hey, ho, before you go, don't forget to click that link.